99.99% turnout recorded in North Korea's single-candidate election. A turnout of 99.99% was recorded in North Korea's election, where each voting slip has only one state-approved candidate on it, the state media said on Tuesday. The vote was held to elect members to the parliament known as the Supreme People's Assembly, SPA. North Korean leader Kim Jong-un did not run for parliament. According to reports, Indian man who mistakenly crossed into PAK released after 7YRS Ghulam Qadir. An Indian national who mistakenly crossed into Pakistan nearly 7 years ago was released by the Pakistani authorities on Monday. He was released following the completion of his jail term for entering the Pakistani territory illegally. Qadir was handed over to the Border Security Force, BSF, at the Wagah border crossing. New York Times calls Pulwama terror attack explosion. Criticized American newspaper, The New York Times is being criticized after it referred to the February 14 terror attack in JNK's Pulwama as explosion. If Pulwama was an explosion, 9/11 was a plane crash. It's very insensitive of NYT, a person tweeted. After facing backlash, The New York Times replaced the word explosion with bombing. We've full confidence in the safety of 737 MAX Boeing after crash. After various countries grounded their Boeing 737 MAX fleet following Ethiopian Airlines crash that killed 157, U.S. aircraft maker Boeing said, safety is Boeing's number one priority and we have full confidence in the safety of 737 MAX. We'll continue to engage with the regulatory agencies to ensure they've info needed to have confidence in operating their fleets, it added. Sun read about it on internet. Dad of Indian woman killed in crash. Satish Garg, father of Shikha Garg, who was one of the four Indians killed in the Ethiopian Airlines crash, has revealed he came to know about the accident after his son read about it on the internet. I knew she was on that flight, he added. Satish further said she had called him less than an hour before the crash.